Hello there! Thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we learn how to create a storage account and how to upload a blob file to it. And we have Matt DiPietro to show us that, so thank you very much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me. Yeah, to start with creating a storage account, we're going to select Create a Resource, and then select the storage account type. In the storage account create, we're currently in the Basics tab. In the Basics tab, all you have to do is type in a storage account name, and you're ready to go.
Wow. Just that simple?
It's that simple.
And this is very similar to the pattern that we have for VMs, where we have a set of tabs. There's a Basics tabs that when you provide the information that is needed there, you're done, right?
That is correct. In this case, we could proceed out of the Basics tab. However, I do want to go over some of the other options. For example, in Performance, we currently have standard and premium performance storage accounts. If I was to select a premium storage account, it's backed by an SSD, so you're going to have faster performance.
Which is always good.
Yes. In addition, we have different types of replication. These are all based on high availability and durability. So if you wanted to learn more about these different types of replication, different account kinds, and what performance tiers I want to use, you can select any of these info tips. It's going to give you a description on what it is and public documentation to learn more.
Oh, that's really cool.
This is great. From here, like I said, you can select Review and Create, and you're ready to go. However, I do want to go over some of the other options in the Advanced tab. For example, Secure Transfer Required. It's currently enabled, so that essentially says that only HTTPS traffic is allowed to access the storage account. In addition, we have virtual networks that allow you to say, for this storage account, I only want to access it based off of this virtual network.
Oh, that's really cool. Yep.
So if I was to click Review and Create, we're going to the Review and Create tab. As of right now, it's running a final validation to make sure that everything passes. If something was to fail, it'll give you the reason why and how to go do it and fix it.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. So validation passed, and we can create the storage account.
And in this case also, you're showing me a summary of what I selected in case that I made any mistakes or I want to correct anything, right?
Correct.
Perfect. So now you submitted the storage account creation request. What is going to happen next?
We're going to take you into the post-create experience, and this is going to give you information about what's going on with the storage account. So as of right now, it's deploying and it's showing you the status that is currently in deployment.
So I can get kind of like near real-time status of how my deployment is going.
That's correct.
That's really cool. And this is very similar. In fact, it's the same than the one that we are using for VM, right? Yes. For virtual machines.
Yes. I mean.
Cool, cool. So right now we are deploying, and I think it will take a few seconds until we are going to be done, right?
Yes. Yeah, so as you can see right now, the deployment is underway. And you can learn more about additional resources during this experience as well.
Great. Oh, it's done now.
Yeah. So now that the deployment is complete, I can actually go to the resource. So I'm going to click Go to Resource. Now we're in the storage account that we just created. The next step will be to actually upload the blob. As you can see, we're currently in the storage account overview, in which I can select the blob service. Before I can upload a blob, I need to create a container. We could think of this as the folder that's going to host all of your files.
Good. Container ready.
Okay, now I'm going to open that container and then upload my file. So if I click on the upload button, I'm going to select the file that's on my desktop and then click upload.
That's it?
That's it.
But, and you didn't need to use any tool other than the Azure portal to create the storage account and upload the blob, right?
That is correct. Only the Azure portal is needed.
Really cool. And is there any other way in which I can inspect my storage account and get access to that blob?
Yeah, so we just announced a Storage Explorer preview. And in Storage Explorer, this is an easy way to manage all of your containers within that storage account. So some of our customers have over hundreds of containers, and this is an easy way to see that list and then manage the blobs within each container more easily.
And also, this tool looks really familiar. This is the same Storage Explorer that we had outside of the portal, now fully integrated in the portal, right?
This is the same experience as the client, yes.
That's really great, Matt. This is great. Yeah. This is awesome.
So as I've shown, this is an easy way to create a storage account, upload your first blob, and then show you management within Storage Explorer preview.
Thank you very much.
Hey, thanks for having me again.
And thanks every one of you for watching this video. Please try storage accounts in the portal, upload your blobs, look them with the Storage Explorer, and let us know what you think in the comments of this video or follow us on Twitter. Look forward to seeing you in the next video, and thanks for watching.